Hello, everybody. This is Ultimate Life Form RB, and welcome back to the Mega Man X playthrough. In our last episode, we took on Armored Armadillo, our fifth Maverick, and now it is time to move on to our next Maverick, which is going to be Launch Octopus. So let's get to it. Now, befitting his design based off of an aquatic animal, Launch Octopus's stage is the obligatory water stage, and you're going to be dealing with some of the usual hazards of a water stage. You're going to be dealing with water, of course, and you're also going to be dealing with aquatic-themed enemies. So, obligatory water stage, here we go. Now, I have been praising Mega Man X's soundtrack in certain episodes of this playthrough, but I have to say, I consider Launch Octopus's theme, it's not a bad tune, but personally I think this music track for Launch Octopus may be my least favorite music track in the game. I don't know what it is. I never really liked Launch Octopus's music track. Like, again, it's not a bad track. There's no real truly bad music track in this game. The soundtrack of this game is excellent, but Launch Octopus's theme never did it for me. Anyway, that mook right there can be rather annoying to deal with. It launches out these eel-type enemies that come after you in a pattern, and it will also try to suck you towards it with a vacuum, so you need to be very careful. That one isn't so bad, but we're coming across one that is very annoying to deal with. Right about... now! This particular iteration of this enemy is very annoying, because now you have to deal with the suction over spike pits. My strategy? Stay on the far left of the screen, where I am right now, and simply dash against the grain when it tries to suck you in, and you should be fine. The eel enemies can be kind of annoying, especially with the patterns they come at you with, but the damage they do really isn't that bad. Just simply spam your X Buster and you'll be fine. Oh, geez, I almost dropped right off. That would have been embarrassing. I did all that trouble to avoid being sucked into the spikes, and I almost stepped off. Now, for this stage, there is actually a hidden mini-boss that you have to look for, and to find it, you'll want to jump on this vortex generator, and jump out to here, and you'll be on this battleship, or this boat, or whatever it may be, and you want to shoot that blue core, simply spam with your X Buster, don't need to use any special weapons here, and it will drop down. Apologies for the slowdown, ladies and gentlemen. Once again, we had slowdown in the last episode. That is the emulator, that is not the game itself. So here's where we take on a mini-boss. This sea serpent type enemy. This guy really isn't a challenge. He has no real attacks to speak of. And he has two weak points. His head is his weak point, as well as his tail. And when he comes down low, you can just jump on his back and repeatedly shoot at his head. He can only hurt you by touching you. He has no projectiles or any special abilities to speak of. Now, once you take him out, you can go over to here and get a heart tank. So our health is expanded once again. And now we can simply get to Launch Octopus. So now all we have to do is get to the Maverick himself, and we'll be able to knock off this level relatively quickly. Once again, only doing one Maverick for this video, so this is going to be quite a short one. And once again, another mini boss, but this time he's going to be coming out of the ground. So a little different in how he's going to play out, but same strategy: jump on his back and just unload on his head. Really not that threatening at all. You can also attack his tail. So yeah, very, very manageable mini-boss. Just gotta wait for him to drop back down. Underwater physics do apply here, so Mega Man X will jump higher in water as opposed to the open air, much like Mega Man does in classic Mega Man. Except for Mega Man 1, where he did not have reduced gravity underwater. Oh, Oh, geez, I ended up under him. Got him! Although I did take a bit of a beating in this run, I'm not exactly at the amount of health I would like to be at for Launch Octopus. But if I have to use a sub-tank, I will. Hopefully I can get away with not using one. Here we are, the boss door. For Launch Octopus, you'll want to use the Rolling Shield, the weapon we got for defeating Armored Armadillo. That is his weakness. Although this fight can be trouble even with the weakness if you don't know exactly what you're doing. Alright, Launch Octopus, let's do this thing. Or Hentai Man, as one of my commenters called him. Thanks, whoever said that. Now I'm having trouble getting that image out of my head. I'm wondering, there's got to be an X-rated Mega Man hack somewhere that has someone called that. I swear. With some of the things people come up with these days, there's probably some X-rated Mega Man hack with an enemy called that. Anyway, what Launch Octopus will do is he will launch torpedoes at you. He will also do a whirlpool attack to try to draw you in. And don't let him touch you with his tentacles, because what he will do is he will latch onto you and he will actually drain health. Oh yes, got him on the rebound! The rolling shield bounced off the wall and back. Nicely done. Trick shot. I probably could have gotten through that without having to use a sub-tank, but I didn't want to take a chance. You get Homing Torpedo, yes! It's supposed to say Homing Torpedo, but instead there's a typo. Great localization there, Capcom. But anyway, there's our password. And now we are down to just two Mavericks left. We have Boomer Kowanger and Sting Chameleon. The next one in line will be Boomer Kowanger, but you're going to have to wait until the next episode to see what he's all about, because we are stopping here. That is a wrap on this episode of the Mega Man X playthrough. If you folks liked what you saw, be sure to like and leave a comment and tell me what you think. We are down to two Mavericks left, and we will be taking on Boomer Kowanger next. So this is Ultimate Life from RB signing out. I will see all of you in the next episode.